when I first learned that we were going to have to be mostly remote, it was a disappointment.
The students were going to feel isolated.
The first thing we thought of was, okay, how can we give them the exact same education or as close to it, but not require them to be on campus, not require them to be in the same space?
How do we make the semester so that it works both from an academic perspective and from a personal perspective, from a community perspective?
And that was definitely overwhelming. But we didn't hesitate. We just immediately started coming up with ideas.
I think a lot of the content can be delivered effectively in an asynchronous way. But that doesn't allow a teacher to understand where the student is in terms of learning, in terms of understanding. So the synchronous times are really important. And this is the idea that brought the concept of mailing each student a kit. A class kit, so that we can interact online to understand how what we teach has bearing in the physical world.
Which is absolutely crucial to the learning. It's Menzie Manis at MIT.
My basement is totally taken over by the preparation of this remote kit. We have pool noodles to simulate beams and shafts, exercise elastic bands to do uniaxial loading, a Twizzler to look at what is a positive or a negative angle of twist for a shaft in torsion. It's a compromise between rigorous mechanics and a little bit of fun.
Our plan is to basically have people on call to answer questions anytime during the week. We have, over the years, tried to build a welcoming and friendly community. That's the thing that I'm hoping to translate the most.
In the laboratory space, we created a studio space. We have lights, camera, kind of like a Hollywood studio, but for mechanical engineering. With this shared space, the instructors are going to be able to interact with the students effectively.
What I'm doing right now is developing a system that I can get every student's eyes on every piece of equipment that they will touch in the course. I'm basically running my own little newsroom, and the objective there is to get them as comfortable as possible before they enter into the shop. They need to understand how to control an injection molding machine so they can know how the parameters directly affect the parts. So when they show up, rather than them having a blank slate, they've already done 25%, 50% of what I need. And that's going to be the standard from now on.
This process is simultaneously very exciting and extremely daunting.
This is a really great challenge.
What we learn from this will carry forward into new ways of teaching.
What we're attempting is a completely novel structure for us.
We are going to go all out in terms of resources.
So they're going to get a good class. Don't worry. We got this. Everything's going to be fine. I think it'll be better in the long run. Mm-hmm.